All right, well, these are my friends. This is Jack, Seymour, Tyrone, and of course, you know, Sam.
It's nice to meet you.
M'lady.
Je parle français.
Wait a second, you've introduced her to your family, but not your Seymour and Tyrone?
Yeah,
I usually save them for last because I don't want people to get freaked out and run away.
I do the same thing.
That's weird. Usually when I meet new people, I like to front load the weird, so I introduce those two first.
It's nice to be talked about.
What about Keegan, though? You said he'd be here.
Well, that's kind of a long story.
Does it have to be?
Well, if you want a compelling narrative, yes.
All right, then. I'm all yours.
Well, it all started when Drew and I got a text saying that Seymour, Tyrone, Jack, and Gwen were all fighting with each other.
Who's Gwen?
Oh, right, you don't know her. Okay, instead of having me describe it, just imagine that she looks like you, all right?
All right, sure.
All right, well, started last week.
Hey, Gabe.
Hey, guys.
Where did it go?
Yeah, sorry it took so long. I had to feed Cuddles.
Who or what is
He's
Cuddles?
He's a raccoon.
Okay, you guys ready to go?
What's the rush? We got some weird text from someone named Adrian saying that Gwen, Jack, Seymour, and Tyrone were at each other's throats, so we kind of want to get there before they kill each other.
And you believed this text?
Well, we had no reason not to believe it. And the idea of Seymour and Tyrone causing an argument really isn't that hard to believe.
Why am I coming?
Well, because you're a good mediator and you're the only one that the six of us have no problems with.
It's quite the compliment, really.
So we're off to rescue our friends from a mysterious conflict? I guess this would make a good final adventure, but a villain would have made it better.
What are you talking about?
This is my last adventure with you guys.
Wait, what? Why?
I got a job offer in LA, so I'm moving out there.
When are you leaving?
In 2 days.
Why wouldn't you tell us?
I didn't want to upset anyone. I thought leaving a heartfelt letter and walking away into the mist would be the most cinematic way to go.
Oh, Keegan, that would leave your audience unsatisfied and angry.
Well, now I gotta rewrite my romantic comedy.
Keegan, I'm not sure if I'm ready for you to leave.
I don't want to leave either, but I can't turn this offer down.
Alright, but we really gotta get going, so we'll talk about this later.
Onward! There they are, they're in the park.
What are they doing?
I think they're fighting. It can't be that bad though, right?
Wait, some of that wasn't right.
Like what?
Like the season, our hair, for instance?
Well, it's called creative license.
I think I'm going to finish the story if that's okay.
All right, fine, if you insist.
Well.
Get him, Tyrone!
Kill him, Seymour!
Excellent.
A very advanced copy of your yearbook.
Where'd you guys get that?
Some journalist crybaby.
Couldn't take a taser like a man.
Well, how does it look?
Well, we are in it very much.
Do you think there's a reason for that?
Not anything that I can think of. Well, you'll be happy to know that you two are in it quite a bit.
Really?
Indeed. The centerfold is a picture of you two as homecoming king and queen.
And you won most of the superlatives. Nicest, cutest couple, most likely to succeed, and best eyes. That's very odd. Obviously, they haven't seen mine.
I'm beginning to think people like you two more than they like us.
Who does a guy have to tase around here to get some recognition?
Hey, while I have you guys here, the school is getting a grant from this guy, and since I'm a student council president, they asked me to show him around. But tonight is mine and Gwen's 6-month anniversary, so... I mean, normally I wouldn't ask you guys to do this, but I'm kind of out of options. Could you show him around?
What's his name?
I think it was Adrian?
What's his last name?
I'm not really sure. Why? Is there a problem?
Possibly. We once knew someone by that name.
Over the next 5 minutes, Gwen will suggest finding someone else for the job. Jack will shrug off this notion, seeming especially driven to atone for his past failings as a boyfriend. Seymour and Tyrone hesitantly accept the task, warning Jack and Gwen of what could go very, very wrong. The importance of this moment will be revealed to you later once all of the pieces have come into play. I will now let you return to the show. Though don't forget, when history tells a story, it is rarely an exact account. Be on the lookout for alterations made by our slightly incompetent storytellers. Now back to somewhere upstate.
Get him, Tyrone!
Kill him, Seymour!
It's your fault!
No, it's your fault!
She left because of you!
No, and that was on you!
What the hell are you guys doing? Anyone? What's going on?
It was your fault,
Jack!
Man.
You!
It was
your fault!
It was you!
It was you!
Keegan Chauffeur, Private Eye. Tell me what happened prior to the conflict.
Well, it all started when Jack and I had our anniversary dinner.
So I got you something.
Oh, wow. That's really sweet of you. Thanks.
Welcome.
I really appreciate the effort you've been making lately. It means a lot.
Well, hey, you deserve it.
Well, happy anniversary.
Happy anniversary.
I don't know why you keep doing this. You just don't understand why you always have to.
What's the matter, guys?
What's the matter? Is this backstabbing Bartley guy?
No, it's this traitor's soup du jour.
I wanted that lemon.
No, it's mine now.
I need that lemon.
No, it's mine.
What's the matter, guys?
Our friend Adrian was kind enough to bring an old conflict to new light, where I realized that he is...
No, he is.
The reason she left.
Take that back.
You cantaverous cuttlefish.
You fiendish ferment!
Guys, hold on. I'm sure we can work something out.
Yeah, let's just try to calm down a little bit.
Oh, that reminds me. He also has some information that the cutest couple in town would want to know.
Jack, did you know that Gwen still harbors feelings for Sam?
You do?
And Gwen, did you know that Jack here shared a kiss with an aggressive-looking blonde?
You did?
So this entire time, you never had any feelings for me?
Excuse me, you cheating on me was much worse.
I did not cheat on you. She kissed me. I never had any feelings for her. I'm like, you had feelings for Sam the entire time.
Yeah, but I never acted on those feelings. Unlike you did, apparently.
Well, Tyrone and I have to go, train to fight to the death, so...
Hold on. I'll help you.
What now?
You know what? I'm gonna help Tyrone. May the best man win.
Deal.
See you in the ring.
Where'd he come back?
Feel the high, we got to learn to fly, we got to take it to the sky on the wings of an eagle.
Which brings us to now.
Well, did you guys at least try talking to each other?
Now correct me if I'm wrong, but all of your problems started after something that this Adrian fellow said?
Oh yeah.
You think it would be possible that he had something to do with all this?
Yeah, he did kind of set us all against each other.
Wait, Tyrone! That villain Adrian has struck again!
Why do we always let him do this?
I know.
So you two know him?
Yes. We knew him in our youth. He took a special pleasure from tormenting us and turning us against each other.
But the real question is why he would choose all of you to torment as well.
Well, do you know where we can find him?
This is the address the school gave us.
Alright, the three of us will go check that out. In the meantime, you guys think you could try to work this out?
I am sorry, my friend. I know it was not your fault that she left.
I know. I don't blame you either.
Some wounds never truly heal, and bleed again at the slightest word.
Well put, friend. Well put.
I'm sorry.
It's not that I don't care for you very much.
It's just I'm your second choice.
No, it's just old habits, I suppose.
Also, I swear I don't have any feelings for her. It was an accident. I'm not perfect, no matter what people seem to think.
So does this all mean we have to break up?
I mean, typically people would. Do you want to?
No. But I think maybe we just weren't meant to be together.
Yeah, I think so.
It doesn't mean you're not still my best friend, though.
So are we good?
We're good.
Our conflicts are resolved. Now would you kindly go deal with that villain for us?
Rollout team. Last ride of the Three Musketeers.
Okay. Well, this first address I think is right by the museum, and the second one I don't think even exists.
I don't even think that's a real road.
Nope, that's where he is.
Wait, what do you mean, why?
Because he'd want to choose an address that seems non-existent, so no one would know to look for him there.
Or the school gave a wrong address.
Alright, I'll go investigate the mystery address, and you guys can go to the other one.
Well, wait, Keegan! If this is the last day we're gonna see you, I don't know if I really want us splitting up.
Oh, don't worry. It'll only be for an hour.
I know, but...
Don't worry. I'll see all you guys soon, and then I'll be right back for that big send-off party that you guys planned for me.
He doesn't actually expect us to have a party, right? I mean, he just told us he was leaving like an hour ago.
Are you kidding? Knowing Keegan, we should probably pick up balloons and snacks on the way to that address.
Yeah.
Hey Drew, can you help me remember to tell work that I won't be able to come in tomorrow?
You have something planned or something?
Well, if tomorrow's the last day we can spend with Keegan, I just want to make good use of that time.
Yeah, but you have to think, he's also not going to be gone forever. We're going to see him again.
Yeah, but I mean, I need to make up for that lost time that he won't be here, so I just gotta try to cram in as much as possible before he goes.
Look, it's not going to be that different. I mean, it's just gonna be a little bit of a change, that's all.
Great.
Are you okay?
Yeah, it's just a cold.
Are you sure? I mean, you think I haven't noticed that it's been getting worse?
It's just a little strep throat. It's nothing big.
Alright. Hey, that Adrian guy just texted me.
But how did he... Wait, what did he say?
It says... Jack stole my idea for a movie?
Drew lied about reading my book.
Sam broke my sword!
Tyrone got me banned from the library.
Gwen forgot my birthday!
Seymour killed my fish!
Turn the car around!
Come in! Hello, Keegan. Please, take a seat.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Can I offer you anything to drink? A beverage, perhaps?
Do you have any Tang?
Tang? It's what the astronauts drink.
Sorry, we're fresh out of Tang.
So you must be Adrian.
That is correct.
And are you the one who's been pitting my friends against each other?
And why would I do that?
I don't know yet.
That's not fair, is it? To come in here and accuse me without any definable motives? It hurt someone's feelings.
You were the one to tell those secrets to get everyone against each other.
Sorry, my friend. I don't know what to tell you. Piece of candy.
Now listen to me. These are my friends you're messing with, and I can't let that continue to happen. These guys are the most important people to me in the world, and I will not let some villain like you get in their heads. Okay?
I admire your spirit, Keegan, but it's a shame you're gonna have to leave. I would like to add you to one of the pieces of my game.
What do you mean?
The art of manipulation, Keegan, is a fine art. A few choice words is all it takes to turn friend against friend. When done expertly, the ensuing fireworks are a delight to watch. I'll admit, turning your friends wasn't my finest work. I've got plenty of time to think bigger. I knew I wanted to turn Seymour and Tyrone against each other, but it was so much more delicious taking down the new friends with them.
Why would you do this?
It's fun!
I'll tell them all. I'll tell everyone what you did.
Go ahead. I'm back to the park. They're probably all there fighting anyway. But keep this in mind. As soon as you leave here, I'll be gone too. So, you have a choice. Stop the fighting now, or stop the fighting in the future.
Guys! What are you guys doing? Fighting with each other? Over what? Some petty squabbles? Now here's the thing. When a bunch of people like each other enough to become close friends, they're inadvertently going to annoy each other. It's a fact. The other fact is that, in a way, you become family. Gwen and Jack are the mom and dad. Sam and Drew are your guys' uncles. And Seymour and Tyrone, they're the crazy senile grandfathers.
Anyways, what I'm trying to say is that families make mistakes. And you just have to accept each other for that. And move on.
He's right. It's been good knowing all of you. Had some really fun times, and I have to get going. I hope I get to see all of you again. If you're ever in LA, you could come to visit. Not to stay, but just to visit. LA gets old.
Keegan, where are you going? You still got 2 days!
Yeah, but this is the most cinematic way I could exit. And that's all I've ever wanted.
Well, he's right. We should just let him have it.
So, what do you guys want to do now, then?
We could play strip poker.
No, whenever you guys play strip poker, you're always purposely losing.
I would call it purposely winning.
Well, Keegan's leaving got me thinking. And I got offered this internship outside Boston. And I thought that if Keegan can go off and do great things, why can't I too, you know? So my sister and I got an apartment in Worcester, and I'm leaving in a week.
No!
What?
No one else is leaving, all right? Too much is changing in too little amount of time. No one else gets to leave.
Sam, I've already made the arrangements.
Gwen, if you stay, we could go out on a date again. I mean, you still like me, right? Win-win.
Sam,
no!
I actually better get going. I just wanted to say bye. It was really awesome knowing you guys. Stay in touch.
Hey.
Bye.
Yep.
And that brings us to now.
Wow, you guys had a really rough week.
Yeah, kinda.
Wouldn't it have been easier just to show me a photo of Gwen so I don't have to try to imagine myself looking like her?
You think we would have thought of that.
So you guys are down two people from the group, right?
Yeah, we'll need to bring in a replacement quick so the audience doesn't get bored.
Who are you thinking? Oh, okay. I'm flattered, I think.
And you thought they wouldn't like you.
And besides, it'll be good to add a female to the group because last time it was just us guys hanging out, we all ended up dancing around the room to It's Raining Men.
And that was after Seymour and Tyrone won strip poker.
Yeah, we did!
I don't think you understand how little we wanted to see that. You know you loved it.
There's still one thing I don't understand, though. How did that Adrian guy know so much about you?
Yeah, he was kind of creepy.
But you two said you knew him once, right?
Indeed. He is a manipulative and evil man. We fear this may be the beginning of some long-term scheme.
We already checked his house, but it was abandoned. He may have fled.
Tyrone and I'll look into it.
He got one thing wrong, though.
What's that?
It wasn't a girl I kissed.
Twist.
Lemon. Do you want lemon?
I hate you.
It was a squid-eat-man world until one man dared to eat squid.
Well, so let's go.
I found the mouse and somebody definitely stepped on it.
Oh, God. It was an accident. Don't have any feelings
There's
for her.
There's a horse driving.
I'm not perfect. Action.
Hold on. It's gonna pass. I'm not crazy. Two black cars. And then a horse.
Oh,
I was right.
Is there a funeral here?
Oh. Get this on camera.
Hurry up. Three, two, one, just do your thing.
Yeah! Hooray!
Samuel L. Jackson.
Dear Major Marquis, how are you? I'm fine. Although I wish there were more hours in the day. I have to go now. Old Merry Todd's coming. Oh, Mary Todd, that's a nice touch.
Hello there, Mr. President. As you may be aware, I recently purchased a smallish dog with a rather large dog collar. I also spent several $1 million on these special headphones. You may be thinking, why are they so special? But Mr. President, that is not the real question here. The real question is, where is my job? Where is my job, Mr. President? Jobs! We need our jobs.
But this is the most cinematic way I could exit. And that's all I've ever wanted. Return my library books!